Everyone, in this class I will explain about explanation of the differential rare axials and its types. In yesterday's class we will discuss about the transmission systems. In the transmission systems, so many different types of transmission systems are discussed, and also the power should be developed in engine of the automobile vehicle. So if that power is transmitted through different transmission systems of the automobile vehicle, in that power is converted into torque by using different clutches or torque converter systems. That type of torque is converted through different axles, that is front axle drive, rear axle drive, or individual drives, or four wheel drives. These are the different types of drives. The torque should be transmitted through these drives. A main component is used in that transmission of torque, that is propeller shaft. In that propeller shaft, we already discussed in yesterday's class, there are different types of propeller shafts. In that different types of propeller shafts, we have torque converter type and Hotchkiss type propeller shafts are discussed in yesterday's class. Today we will see about the differential rear axles and its types. In this differential rear axles, there are different types. It is Hotchkiss type rear axle and a torque type rear axle. These are the two different types of rear axles in the automobile vehicle. First of all, we will see about the what is differential and what is the purpose of the differential in the automobile vehicle. Why it is important and what type of components involved in the differential in automobile vehicle. And this differential is connected through the rear axles, and how the connection between this differential and rear axles, and what are the different components placed in the rear axles, and what type of differential axles used in the automobile vehicles. These topics we will see in this class. First of all, what is differential? So the differential is a mechanical device to transmit the torque at rear wheels or front wheels or four wheel drives of the automobile vehicle. So differential is play a very big vital role on the automobile vehicle. Why? Because the torque should be converted through this propeller shaft, and the wheels are rotating based upon this differential. For example, the car is running on a road. It is a forward direction or a reverse direction. The wheels are rotating. How that wheels are rotating? How that power flow, the torque should be transmitted to that wheels. Based upon this differential, the torque is transmitted through propeller shaft. In this connection, there are different gears and the different mechanisms are used to convert this torque at the rear axles or front axles or different axle drives. Based upon this differential, the wheels are rotating. In that wheels, there are shafts are connecting through this differential. That's why the wheels are rotating through this differential. Okay, so that is the mechanical device of these differential. Why it is called mechanical device? It is, there is a mechanism is placed in the differential. So the propeller shaft is connected through the differential input shaft, and the differential output we have connected with the wheel shafts. So that wheel shafts is connected through differential at different mechanism. In that mechanism, there are different types of gears are used to convert the motion, to convert the motion of that input propeller shaft to the output differential of the automobile vehicle. You can see what is differential. A differential is a device usually but not necessary employing gears capable of transmitting torque and rotation through three shafts. Almost always used in one of two ways. In one way, it receives one input, provides two outputs. This is found in most automobiles. In the other way, it combines two inputs to create an output, that is the sum difference or average of the inputs. So it is the differential. So what is told, what is the definition of this differential, and what is the purpose of differential? It is, a differential is a device that is usually but not necessary employing gears. So it is a device to convert the motion of the propeller shaft. The torque should be transmitted through wheels of the automobile vehicle, but not necessary employing gears. The gears are not necessary. There are different types of gears to transmit the torque to the wheels. Capable of transmitting torque and rotation through three shafts. Transmitting of torque and rotation through three shafts. One shaft is propeller shaft. It is connected through the differential input shaft. That is one shaft. And another shaft is, in the rear wheel drive, we have two wheels. In the two wheels, it is connected to two shafts. In the two shafts are connected through differential output shaft. So those are the three shafts in the auto rear wheel axle of the automobile vehicle. Almost always used in one of two ways. In one way, it receives one input and provides two outputs. So the input is taken from the propeller shaft. The torque should be developed in transmission system. In the transmission system, the torque should be transmitted through propeller shaft to the differential. So in that differential, that is one input, and the output to provides the both wheels of the rear axle, that is output of the automobile vehicle. It is found in most automobiles. In other way, it combines two inputs to create an output, that is the sum difference or average of the inputs. So in this type of output should be transmitted through automobile wheels in different ways, at a combining of two inputs are to create an output, and the that is the sum difference or average, any type of we can take and to develop the output on the automobile vehicle. So what are the automobile engineers use the differential at a different ways. So different types of differentials are used in the automobile vehicles to transmit the torque to the different rear wheel drives or different wheel drives of the automobile vehicle. You can see the what are the different types of differential placed in the automobile vehicles. Is one is left side movement of the differential, and the right side movement of the differential, and the inside axle of the that is right side movement of the differential. So the differential, how it works. So many different types of differentials are used in the based upon the different types of automobile vehicles. If one differential I am taking, what is the running position of the differential, and what type of shafts are activating and through running position of the automobile vehicle. Suppose the vehicle running on a road, it turns a left side. It turns left side on the road. So the vehicle turns left side. So in that vehicle turn left side, you can see the differential input shaft and the differential output shafts of the rear wheel drive, how it should be rotated. So what type of gears he is using, what type of gears meshed to the differential input gears. So what are the different gears are used in the differential frequency, and what type of direction should be rotates in the differential. You can observe there is a outside axle turns faster. There is a outside axle turns faster. So the vehicle moves left side. The vehicle turns left side of the road, then the outside axle turns at faster. So the outside axle turns at very high speed, then inside axle turns slower. The inside axle, it turns slower and it rotates very slow speed, and the spider gears spin. Thus you can see the spider gears. So the spider gears also rotates in the direction of left side of the vehicle. And next one, you can see the vehicle moves on a road at stride. So the vehicle running at stride, you can see the axles turn at same speed. The both axles of the differential, it turns and rotates at the same speed. Bearing, side gear and ring gear. So what are the different types of gears meshing through the internal gears of the differential? Okay. And next one, the vehicle turns right side of the road. So the inside axle turns slower. The inside axle turns slower and the outside axle turns faster. So both axles are rotates, but the inside axle is turns slower and the outside axle turns faster. So these are the different directions the vehicle runs on a road. It is the vehicle turns left side and the vehicle runs right side, and the vehicle running at stride on the road. These are the different positions, the gears and the axles. What is the motion and what is the speed told in this diagram. So a cutaway view of a car final drive unit which contains the differential. So it shows the cut sectional view of the differential. So in that differential, what type of mechanism is placed? What is involved in that differential? It shows is a mechanism is placed in that differential. There are different types of gears used to convert the motion of the rear axle. Okay, so the propeller shaft is connected to one joint of the differential input shaft. In that differential, it is converts the motion of the rear axle. So in that motion comes from the propeller shaft. That motion should be converted by using different types of mechanisms. Different types of gears are used to convert these motion to the rear axle to rotate the automobile wheels. In automobiles and the other wheeled vehicles, the differential allows each of the driving road wheels to rotate the different speeds, while for most vehicles supplying equal torque to each of them. In automotive applications, the differential housing is sometimes colloquially called a pumpkin, as the differential housing typically reassembles a pumpkin. So in automobile and other wheeled vehicles, the differential allows each of the driving road wheels. So any type of different automobile vehicles running on the roads, the differential is placed and it plays a vital role on the automobile vehicle. The main purpose of the differential to convert the motion of the propeller shaft to the rotating the wheels of the automobile vehicle. Okay. So the driving road wheels to rotate at different speed. So we are maintaining different speed of the automobile vehicle. The vehicle turns left side and right side, and the vehicle moves stride. There are the differential. The differential should play a very good response to the running of the vehicle, on the left side and slight motion of the vehicle to reduce the speed and to increase the speed of the wheels. That is the main purpose of differential used in the automobile vehicles. So what is the purpose of differential? The differential is designed to drive a pair of wheels with equal force. It is allowing it's rotate at different speed. So we are maintaining different speeds of the automobile vehicles. The vehicle turns side and the vehicle moves the right directions. The speeds are different. So in that speeds are different to control the differential. In vehicles without a differential, such as crafts, both driving wheels are forced to rotate at the same speed. Usually on a common axle driven by a simple chain drive mechanism. In vehicles without a differential, in some vehicles there is no differential. So in such parts, both driving wheels are forced to rotate at the same speed. Both wheels, the front axle wheels and the rear axle wheels are running at same speed. Okay. Usually on a common axle driven by a simple chain drive mechanism. So through this same speed, to get the connection of a common, a simple chain drive mechanism to maintain the same speed of the automobile vehicles. When cornering, the inner wheels needs to travel a shorter distance than the outer wheel. So with no differential, the result is the inner wheel spinning and the outer wheel dragging. And this result in difficult and unpredictable handling, damaged tires and roads, the strain of the entire drivetrain. When cornering, the inner wheel needs to travel a shorter distance than the outer wheel. So with no differential, so inner wheels need to be travel a shorter distance, a small amount of distance travel through these inner wheels. The outer wheels, when the outer wheels, so there is no differential, the result in the inner wheel spinning or the outer wheel dragging, when the result is very difficult to unpredictable handling, there is damage to the tires on the roads and the strains of the entire drivetrain. So these are the drawbacks are getting you are not using the differential on the automobile vehicle. You can see what is the functional description of this automobile vehicle. A cutaway drawing of a car rear axle showing the chrome wheel and the pinion of the final drive and the smaller differential gears. There are different types of gears, different sizes of gears are used to convert the motion of the propeller shock to the differential axles. So in that differential axles, it is connected to a differential, a big pair of that differential, it is converts the motion to rotate the wheels of the automobile vehicle. Okay. So in that functional description of the automobile vehicle, torque is supplied from the engine via transmission to a drive shaft, which runs on the final drive unit and contains the differential. So the torque should be transmitted to this propeller shaft by the differential of the rear axle drive, and a spiral bevel pinion rear takes its drive from the end of the propeller shaft and is encased within the housing of the final drive unit. This meshes with the large spiral bevel ring gear known as the chrome wheel. So this meshes with the large spiral bevel ring. Bevel ring gear. So that large spiral bevel ring is also known as the chrome wheel of the automobile vehicle. The chrome wheel gear is attached to the differential carrier or case. That chrome wheel, this type of chrome wheel is attached to the differential carrier or case. Differential carrier is attached to the chrome wheel gear. which contains the sun and planet wheels or gears, sun and planet gears, which are a cluster of four opposed bevel gears in a perpendicular plane. The sun and planet gears. The sun and planet gears. The sun and planet gears are cluster of four opposed bevel gears. Four opposed bevel gears in perpendicular plane. So the sun and planet gears are in perpendicular plane. You can see this diagram. The sun and planet gears are perpendicular plane. Please attach to the chrome wheel gear. Please attach to the chrome wheel gear. The two sun wheel gears are aligned on the same axis as the chrome wheel gear, and the drive wheel axle half shafts connect to the vehicle's driven wheels. The two other planet gears are aligned to a perpendicular axis, which change the orientation with the ring gear's rotation. As the differential carrier rotates, the changing axis orientation of the planet gears imparts the motion of the ring gear to the motion of the sun gears by pushing on the rather than the tunneling against the because of the planet gears. Are not restricted from the turning against each other. In that motion, the sun gears can counter rotate relative to the ring gear and to each other under the same force. So the chrome wheel gear is attached with a sun gear and planet gear. Based upon this sun gear and planet gear, the wheels are moving at different sides of the rows. Based upon this sun gears is attached to the chrome wheel, so the speed should be increased and the speed should be decreased on this differential to the automobile vehicle. The rotation of the chrome wheel gear is always average of the rotations and the side sun gears. So the rotation of chrome wheel is always average of the rotations. It's not maintained a very high amount of speeds, a very low amount of speeds. It should be maintained average speed of the chrome wheel gear and the attachment of these sun gears and the attachment of these side sun gear. So based upon these side sun gears, these rotates through connection of this chrome wheel gear. Okay. This is why if the driven road wheels are lifted clear of the chrome wheel, the engine off and the drive shaft is held, it is leaving the transmission in gear, preventing the ring gear from the turning inside the differential. Manually rotating the driven road wheel causes the opposite road wheel to rotate in the opposite direction of the same amount. When the vehicle is traveling in a straight line, there will be no differential movement of the planetary system of gears, and other than the minute movements necessary of compensate for slight differences in wheel diameter. Undulations in the road which make for a longer or short wheel path. So that is the overall direction of the differential based upon the rotation of differential through different mechanisms is involved in the automobile vehicle system through running on a road of the automobile vehicle. You can see these are the differential and axles placed in the automobile vehicles. You can see it is the differential. It's the differential. In that differential, you can place a mechanism running wheels on the automobile vehicle. So in that differential, we place different types of gears, that is sun and planet gears and chrome wheel gears are placed in the differential. Through various speeds are maintained in the wheels of the automobile vehicle. So that is the live axle, how to connect a differential rear axle in the automobile vehicle. It shows one live example of the road of the automobile vehicle. So it is the differential. displacement in the differential, that is the front axle is connected to, there is a front axle, in the front axle it has a differential, so in the differential it has a front wheels connected through these different shocks. Okay, so a live axle, sometimes called a solid axle, is a type of beam axle suspension system that uses the drive shock to the transmit power of the beams to connect the wheels laterally so that they move together as a unit. Central differential in single housing can also contain the drive shocks that connect the differential to the driven wheels. So the differential is connected to the engine via swing of a drive shock to the universal joint. So that differential is connected to propeller shock through universal joint of the automobile vehicle. So the complete assembly may be take typically may be suspended with leaf spring, coil springs, or airbags. So the suspension system is placed in different ways. That is, leaf springs are used, or coil springs are used. Other airbags are also used to give the suspension of the vehicle. Small trucks, solid front axles have generally been replaced in independent from suspension, and some live axles use trailing arms, semi-trailing arms, fan hot rod, watch linkage to control the vertical and lateral movements of the axle. Others, particularly older vehicles, use Hotchkiss mechanism in which the leaf springs provide axle location as well as suspension in the automobile vehicle. So what are the advantages and disadvantages of these differential used in the automobile vehicle is, there are different loads are acting on the differential. It is static and the bump and rebound loads are acting on the differential. Then the solid axle suspension characteristics, camber, change on bumps, none on rebound, large unsprung weight on the differential, different loads are acting on the this differential. So what the advantages of the differential is, advantages of the light axle are relative simplicity, lower manufacturing cost, lighter overall vehicle weight, and the fact that the axle and suspension systems take up little interior volume because the axle assembly is fairly simple and rigid arrangement. It can easily be made strong and robust, which is an advantage for vehicles with substantial power or the intended use in rugged environments or off-road usage. A further advantage of live beam axle off-road using that ground clearance under the axle remains constant. Even if one wheel rises over a bump and the other doesn't. So in the differential used in the automobile vehicles, is these are the different types of different advantages. You can see the live axle are related to simplicity. So the live axle manufacturing and connection of the automobile vehicle is very simple and lower manufacturing cost. So the manufacturing cost of this differential in the automobile vehicle is also low, lighter overall vehicle weight. Compared to overall vehicle weight, the differential is less weight. And the fact axial and suspension system take up a little interior volume. So the volume of this axle is small volume because the axle assembly is fairly simple and rigid arrangement. So the axle arrangement is also very simple and rigid arrangement. So these are the different advantages by using the differential in automobile vehicles. And also disadvantages. The principal disadvantage is the negative effect on ride quality and handling. So to handle this differential is some difficult, and negative effects are acting on this differential. The wheels cannot move independently in response to the bumps. So the wheels cannot move independently. There is a bump occurred on the automobile vehicles. The wheels are moved independently. The wheels cannot move independently through that bumps. So that is one disadvantage in this using of differential. Although the overall mass of the total suspension is low, so the total suspension is very low by using this differential. These are the different disadvantages and applications it is. And in the front axles and rear axle drives and different trucks or different automobile vehicles, these differentials are used. And the leaf spring, oil spring and banded spring, early Land Rover and Jeep models, Range Rover 1 and 2, Rover ST1, Volvo 250, and the Packard roads, the Ford, that the differential, these type of differentials are used in the different vehicles, automobile vehicles. Okay, so these are the different applications. So coming to main topic of this today's class is rear axle. So in that rear axle, it is connected to differential. Rear axles are structural members on which rear wheels are mounted on bearings. So in the rear axle, the rear wheels are mounted to these bearings. The weight of the body of the automobile and load due to the occupations in transmitter to the springs to the axle casing. So the weight of the overall body acts on the axle casing. So the weight of the overall body is acts on the frame and the connection of the axles. What are the different forces and the torques are developed in the rear axle? Weight of the body, driving thrust, torque reaction, side thrust. These are the different forces and the torques developed in the rear axle. Weight of the body. Rear axle behaves like a beam supported at the ends and loaded at two points. The load coming on the axle is due to the weight of the body being transmitted through the suspension springs. Weight causes shear force and bending on the wheels. And the driving thrust, torque produced by the engine causes the thrust on the wheels. So the torque is produced by the engine. So that causes the thrust on the wheels should be developed. This force is responsible for the forward motion of the vehicle. So the vehicle moves forward direction. This type of force is acting on the rear axle. The drive force from the wheels is transmitted to the body or chassis by means of radius rods or thrust members. These members are in longitudinal directions connecting axle casing and the body. And next one, torque reaction. The torque reaction occurs due to the resistance offered by the wheels of the motion. This causes a torque produced on the axle in the counterclockwise direction when viewed from the left side of the vehicle where wheel drive. So the torque also developed on this rear wheel axle to running a vehicle on the road. So that movement of the wheels at this counterclockwise direction, the torque should be developed on the rear wheel axle drive. So the torque is produced by the braking torque is just the opposite to the torque reaction. Stop reaction and side thrust. These are the different forces or loads are acting on the rear axles. So what are the different types of rear axle drives? We are using different types of rear axle drives. That rear axle drives, Hotchkiss drive and torque tube drive. These are the two types of rear axle drives used in the automobile vehicles. Hotchkiss drive. Already these two types of drives is discussed in yesterday's class. So today we will see about these rear axle drive types. Hotchkiss drive, simplest and most widely used in rear axle drive. So this Hotchkiss drive is simplest and widely used in rear axle drives. The suspension springs take torque reaction driving the thrust and side thrust. So what is the construction of the Hotchkiss drives? The propeller shaft with three universal joints and a sliding joint. The spring is fixed rigidly in the middle onto the frame. And the driving torque is transmitted through the front form of the springs. the front end of the jeep suspension is rigidly fixed onto the frame, while the rear is connected via shock wheel. You can see the shock wheel. The rear is connected through this shock wheel. Okay, so this leaf spring is connected to the frame, and the leaf spring is connected to the differential. Why that leaf spring is placed in that the differential? The bumps are loads are acting on the vehicle running on your road. Different types of loads are acting. That's why the leaf spring is placed to give the best suspension of the vehicle. Okay. Sliding joint is provided to accommodate for the variation of length in the transmission shaft. So the sliding joint is placed to variation of the length in the vehicle. Because the vehicle 10 different sides of the roads, the length of the shaft should be increased. That's why the sliding joint is used. So it is the Hotchkiss drive. It's the diagram of Hotchkiss drive. And next, torque tube drive. Torque tube, braking torque or drive thrust are taking the torque tube. The suspension springs are taking only side thrust and the body weight. And the construction is one end of the torque tube is attached to the axial casing. So the one end of the torque tube is attached to the axial casing. So the axial casing is connected to the one end of the torque tube. The torque tube encloses the propeller shaft. This torque tube is encloses the, it is the torque tube. This torque tube is encloses the, this torque tube is encloses with the propeller shaft. This torque tube takes the torque reaction and the center line of the bevel pinion shaft always passes to the center of the spherical cup. So single universal joint is used in the transmission system drive because the universal joint is situated exactly center of the spherical cup. No sliding joint is provided since the pinion shaft, the propeller shaft moves the same center. Only single universal joint is used in this torque tube. And the other side, the cup is placed, in the cup is directly connected through the frame. Okay, so that is the diagram of the torque tube. And the, what are the rear axial leaf casings? There is a different types of rear axial casings. It is split type casing, banjo or separate carrier type, Salisbury or internal carrier type, split type. You can see this diagram, split type rear axle differential, split type rear axle differential. Okay, the axle casing is made in two halves and then bolted together for assembly. The axle is two halves, it is connection with the help of bolted. And but the main disadvantage is whole rear axle has to be removed as a unit and reassembly in case of a pump. This kind no longer used now. Disadvantage in this split type. A banjo or separate carrier. Axle is made as a single piece. The complete differential unit is separate unit and is bolted to the axle casing. So it is only one single piece differential. If any repair occurs on this differential, the overall differential should be taken out from that axle. The casing and the two shafts are put from these two sides. So the differential is connected to the two different shafts of the two sides of the automobile vehicle. In case of repair, and the shafts can be taken from two sides and two, the differential can be removed easily. So in this case, the removal of the differential is very important. The two shafts should be removed from that differential. Next, Salisbury or integral carrier type. This is similar to the banjo type. I expect that the permanent housing tubes are pressed and welded onto the sides. This is the most common kind of rear wheel drive parts. These are the different parts in the Salisbury type rear axle figure. Okay, so these are the differential rear axles and different types of rear axle drives. It is torque tube type and the Hotchkiss type. Rear axle drives. In next class, we will see about wheels and tires of cross topic in second unit. So, thank you guys.